much for speaking to us today, Stuart.
Hi.
First of all, could you give us a brief description of your chess background?
A brief description, right. I learned chess from my dad. My dad taught me chess when I was about 5.5 years old. And he took me to chess tournaments in London. I played a little bit at school, not too much, I have to say, then. Joined a chess club, had lessons from an older player who was a good sort of counter level player, and I just kind of liked it and got a bit better here and there, and got noticed by England selectors, started playing for the English junior team, and so one thing led to another like that, you know. And then I began playing tournaments when I was at school abroad, traveling to France and Germany, playing for foreign teams, and making a little bit of sort of pocket money here and there, you know. And when I was 18, after good A-level grades, I decided, I had to decide between university and a professional chess career, and I decided, rightly or wrongly, to choose chess. So that's and that's sort of fast forward to today, really.
Excellent. And could you tell us a little bit about what your work as Gibraltar's community chess professional has entailed so far?
Yeah, sure. Well, it's a very exciting new position, possibly unique in the world. I don't know of anyone else who's doing what I'm doing here. So basically, my job is to promote chess in any way I can. In Gibraltar. I've been doing a lot of work with the schools here, with the young people, but also with the adults as well, I have to say, you know. So I'm trying to encourage anyone who already plays chess to play more, or some people sort of, some of the older players used to play chess when they were younger, then they got into other things, so I'm trying to bring them back a little bit. So this chess club this evening, for example, I'm going to that for the adult players. The schools have been great. I've been teaching at sometimes 6 or 7 schools a week in Gibraltar. Many of the middle schools and a couple of the younger ones as well, the first schools, typically at lunchtime chess clubs, helping out, giving advice, bit of coaching, encouraging kids to play more, play at home, play on the internet sometimes, and try and catch their imagination. And I think chess is great for kids. It's good for boys and girls, for, you know, it teaches them all kind of things like decision making, confidence, etiquettes, you know, how you behave towards your opponent, respect, all that kind of stuff. I think chess is really good for kids, especially the younger ones, you know, kids, you know, 7, 8, 9, that kind of age.
Okay.
So it's a lot of schoolwork and it's going well.
Excellent. And what sort of feedback and response have you received so far?
It's all been positive. It's all been good. Yeah. I mean, I'm gradually starting to know more of the kids, more of the parents, the teachers, the head teachers. And also I'm having lots of dealings with, I've met many of the present ministers, the government, to discuss possible projects, plans that we can maybe introduce chess into other parts of the community, such as old people, you know, those with social services, disabled people maybe, maybe the prison as well. I could maybe go up to the prison every so often, and once a month or something, give a little chess talk or something up there. I don't know. I mean, I'm open. I'm trying to come up with ideas, and I'm also open to suggestions from other people who maybe have ideas that I haven't come up with. So it's pretty constructive, positive, and moving forward and trying to encompass more things as I go along.
And what sort of projects do you have that you're working on within the near future?
I have several projects. An exciting one is I'm trying to get a large chess board in Casemates, or even the Piazza, but let's say Casemates, during the summer for some weeks. It hasn't been done before, I don't think. I think that would be exciting. Anyone could play on it, so locals, kids, people, tourists maybe, just coming across the gyp for the day. We need someone to kind of look after it. I'll be there some of the time. I've got a friend of mine from London who might be able to come over and help run it with me. So that's something I'm working on. I think that's going to happen. I hope so.
Okay.
Also, we have a big chess festival here in August at the Coletta Hotel. That's a junior international chess festival. It's our third year we've run it. We've got about 50, 60 kids already entered for that. We've got children coming from Azerbaijan. I think we've got 10 children from Azerbaijan with their mums and dads.
Yeah.
We've got a child coming from the States, a boy coming from India. So it's very international.
Yeah.
So that's something else I'm working on. It's a big event. What else? I'm giving chess lessons as part of the Gibraltar Sports and Leisure Activities in the summer as well, at Bayside Sports Centre. So it's quite a lot happening, and probably more things I can't think of now, but there's a lot of stuff.
Yeah. And on a more personal level, how have you settled into life and work like within Gibraltar?
It's very good. It's nice. Yeah, I mean, people have been very friendly, very welcoming. I mean, I've been coming down to Gibraltar on and off for the past 10 years, so I kind of know my way around a little bit. But I have to say, I'm still finding out new things about Gibraltar, still making lots of new friends. I went to Calentita night this weekend, which is really good. I've never seen that many people in Casemates Square. I can believe it.
Yeah.
Amazing.
It does get very packed.
So great atmosphere. Really enjoyed that. So I went out afterwards and sort of a disco and stuff. Yeah, so I mean, good. Nightlife is good. And I'm just enjoying, you know, going out, meeting people and becoming a bit more part of the community here, let's say. And it's been going well.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for speaking to us.
Thanks.